Hey, Redneck Picker here. I got a couple emails from some people out there that asked some questions about shipping and how do I calculate it and whatnot. I use the post office for probably 95% of my stuff. If anything's bigger, I use either FedEx or I use, believe it or not, Greyhound Bus for your great big stuff. But when you're calculating your shipping expenses, you know what, be very careful because you can shoot yourself in the foot and then at the same time you can sometimes overcharge a customer that's not necessary. I personally don't want to make any money off my shipping. I don't try to make any money off my shipping. In fact, it's in my terms and conditions that if your shipping is less than what I posted, I'll refund you the money at the transaction, and I do that. I mean, I'll PayPal somebody, you know, 75 cents, a buck and a quarter. And you know what? I just think that personally, that's just the honest thing to do. And then if you price your shipping at $13.50 and it costs you $14.25, shame on you. You didn't do your homework. You didn't weigh out your item before you listed your posted thing. You can use the shipping wizard, weigh out your item with a box, with your packing materials, and then it'll calculate exactly what it is. I prefer not to do that because I think it just takes too much time. So I will weigh something out, or I can tell if something's less than a pound. I know it's 544 for priority, 328 at 13 ounces. I've already got all that stuff in my head. So what I would do is simply practice. Go to the USPS.com website and use your use their domestic shipping calculator, and then just start learning. There's different zones across the country, and as the farther away, obviously, the more it is. So go in and practice that. I've got a spreadsheet done with everything on there. And I'm actually getting ready to make myself like a little laminated thing of the country, zone one, zone two, zone three. You know, I hope something like that would help you, but really be careful on that and make sure your stuff's weighed out and, you know, understand the difference between priority and parcel and media and first class and how big your package can be. So just go in and do the practice on there. Compare things too. Go to USPS.com, the post office. And put in a large, you know, 35-pound box, see how much it costs. Then go over to UPS and do a time and shipping calculation on there. And you can compare what's easier for you, what's easier for your customer, you know, and then you do what works best for you. I personally am at the post office every stinking day of the week anyway, so I live right down the street from it, so it's super easy for me. I get a roll up to the dock, I use their tubs and haul my stuff in and drop my stuff out. It's super easy, so because I got my own postage stuff. So as far as shipping goes, you know what? Again, you know, just practice, so it's kind of in your head. But if ever in doubt, weigh your item, make sure that you've calculated your shipping costs as far as it will go. And just, you know, do it that way, and I find that it works for me, you know. But again, find your sweet spot and what works for you. But, you know, that's my advice, my 2 cents for it. So, anyways, hope you're all having a great day. Everybody's making some money. And thank God for what you have. Be grateful for it. And don't complain about what you don't. Do something about it. Everybody have a great day, and we'll talk to you soon.